What's up, guys? Jonathan Evans here. Just wanted to take some time and share how proud I am of my parents and all the things that they have accomplished, from raising us four kids, me, Anthony, Priscilla, and Crystal, to taking care of now their grandchildren, to the ministry that they've built that started in 1976 and God's faithfulness over the past 43 years, and all the things that I've been able to watch, the blueprint that has been built, and watching them, not just as parents, but as people who love God and are serving His purposes, and the legacy that gets built from that. We all remember, all the siblings, we remember being around the table every night for dinner, and our dad opening up the Bible and teaching us different things, and us having fun and laughter, and the value that my parents placed on that family time. What I'll never forget is Psalm 128. My dad would pull open the Bible, and I remember him saying that this is the passage. This is the passage that we live our life based on, and that our ministry flows from. And that passage just talks about how blessed everyone is who fears the Lord and who walks in His ways, that you will eat the fruit of your hands. You will be happy and it will go well with you. It says, how blessed is the man who fears the Lord. Your wife shall become a fruitful vine in your home. Your children like olive plants around your table. Thus shall the man be blessed who fears the Lord. May you be blessed from Zion. May you see prosperity in Jerusalem all the days of your life. Indeed, may you see your children's children. Peace be upon Israel. And it just lays out his whole ministry philosophy, which is the kingdom agenda, that it starts with the individual that fears the Lord. And you always know that an individual fears God because he walks, or she walks, in His ways. And just to see my parents walking in His ways, starting a ministry locally and then starting a national ministry and preaching God's word, and my mom serving, from doing everything from children's ministry to music ministry when the church was young. And it's just been great to see them live out this legacy that they taught us around that table. And one of the things that they did was go to NRB, the National Religious Broadcasters. Each year, my mom talked about how she would hand out those cassette tapes and give away brochures about the ministry, and stand in that great hall with all of these different ministries just trying to get noticed. But they kept walking the walk, not just talking the talk. They kept being faithful in the small places to get to the place where they are now. And to be able to see that as a son, and I know my siblings would say the same thing, is incredible. And to be at this year's National Religious Broadcasters, to watch my dad get an award as a family, we're sitting around the table that's reminiscent of how we grew up, and we're there. My mom is there, who's been there this entire time, from the big hallway where everybody has a booth, to being at the table where we're about to be recognized for the Hall of Fame, and where my dad is about to get this prestigious award for what he's been able to do and what they together, and we together as a family, have supported for so many years. It's simply outstanding to see that it's gone from the table in our house to the table of the Hall of Fame. And I think that just goes to show of how the ministry has flowed from this philosophy, from being individuals that take care of business to being individuals that take care of family, and having the family there the whole way, even on a special day like this. But then it talks about impact. This same passage, Psalm 128, talks about the impact. And it says, your city will be changed and your nation will be changed, and you'll be able to see your children's children. And so National Religious Broadcasters gave my dad this award because of our broadcast through the Urban Alternative. The Urban Alternative has a broadcast that broadcasts his messages on over 130 countries, on over 1,000 stations, nation and worldwide. And my mom used to start just being faithful as an individual, getting those tapes ready from our garage with my sisters. I wasn't born yet, but my sisters were there doing that with my mom. And to see now that my mom and dad have made it to the Hall of Fame for their impact, not just nationally, but worldwide, goes right back to the philosophy that we learned when we were kids sitting at that table in Psalm 128. And then it ends by saying, indeed, you will see your children's children. My brother was able to sing. My sister's in ministry. I'm in ministry. And now my dad is able to see his children's children because of the faithfulness that he had to the scripture that he and my mom taught us sitting around that table many, many, many years ago. You will be happy. It will go well with you. And it will be fruitful. And to be able to see that from that table to this table, is an amazing thing. Congratulations to Tony and Lois Evans from your son, Jonathan Evans, and on behalf of all of my siblings, we love you.